The following program is brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, one of my favorite songs. Yeah, you're da da. You're a good da, singer, da, but yeah, are you? What exactly are you doing?
I'm roasting my cashews, Kevin.
Well, but it's chestnuts. It's a different kind of a nut. Yes.
Tomato, potato, Kevin. I think it still works.
It still works. You're roasting cashews in a can. That could be a song. Roasting cashews in a can.
Yeah.
Jack Frost nipping at your nose. I love this song.
Oh yeah, it's good.
And although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Roll it. It's the Kevin Shorey Show, taped before a live studio audience in the Branson Mill in Branson, Missouri. Today, Kevin's special guest, Dr. Lee Fredrickson. Special music by Little Lee. And now, Jack Frost nipping at his nose, here's your host, Kevin Shorey.
Yeah!
Isn't it a great day to serve the Lord? Isn't it great? Merry Christmas. I love this beautiful time of the year. This day is like just like 12 days from, like, isn't it 12 days?
Yeah.
12 days or 11 days from Christmas? And those who watch on Uplift TV, it's
still got a shop, Kevin.
A few days before Christmas. Yeah. But you still got a shop?
I still got to get some
gifts. I've got the list. I know what my wife, my daughter, I don't know what
twice,
my son wants.
Kevin?
I've been checking it twice and
good,
three times.
Good.
See if I get better prices.
Yeah.
Making a list, checking the price. That's what I should say. Yes. Because, anyway. But Merry Christmas to everybody. And so it's just a great time of the year. We have a lot of things to cover today, so we got to go quick. I want to thank all our family of friends. Man, the family of friends, which other ministries call partnership, it's growing. The family of friends is growing. When you give a gift of any size, we have different gifts to go with that size. So say if you send a $40 gift, you get the kid's armor. This is great to dispel the radiation or the microwave from the cell phone. Keep your face, your blood from boiling.
Cool.
And it's not an exaggeration. Your blood actually heats up.
Yeah, I might plug in a picture here. I'm editing right now.
You're going to put
picture, show before and after.
Show the before and after
using
the chip.
Yeah,
yeah, that's right. That's that device. Of course, there's the Neo Relief. Mm. This is so good for keeping away. Here, let me read what the inventor says. Temporary relief of minor aches, pain, stiffness of muscles, joints, and tissues associated with arthritis, rheumatism, inflammation, simple backache. It's an anti-inflammatory made naturally with one of its ingredients, which is
poison ivy,
which it's amazing how they do that. But this really, really works.
And it doesn't
get
rid of it. It doesn't get rid of
your arthritis is not going to disappear.
Forever. Yes,
but it's a temporary relief.
Yes.
Yeah. And they're coming up with a new deal that I can't say, but I keep saying all the time. For those with restless leg or leg cramps, it actually, they have a cream coming out that works for that. Now, I couldn't find my Neo Relief, and I was having a bad neck ache yesterday.
Tell the story?
Well, this is made for women that have the menstrual cramps or going through their period and have the pain. This is an anti-inflammatory, too, that you put across your stomach, your abdomen, and ladies, it really helps you, and it helps
the husbands
as well.
Too,
yes, it really helps us. So it's called period relief. But I couldn't find my Neo Relief, so I thought, well, it's an anti-inflammatory.
You put the period relief on
your
head.
I put period relief on my neck, and my forehead. My
headache went away,
disappeared,
though.
The
headache still
so
went away.
So either way, these are good
anti-inflammatory. Yes, that was that's
God
a true story.
Is so good. We're going to talk that's about good. These books and a new offer, but I love our partnership.
And the dollar.
The family of friends. Yeah, before, I think I want to end with that.
Okay.
Because those that give a dollar for every year, I've been in ministry, $33 a month, we send you a free gift every month. A couple gifts, not just one. Two, we've sent prints, greeting cards to you, CDs, DVDs. We've sent all different gifts. I want to do something practical for Christmas. This was invented by a pastor's wife, friends of mine in Rhode Island. It's called the mop cloth, the sweep mop cloth. It's made of microfiber, and you put it on the end of a broom or a Swiffer, and you sweep. You can clean stuff, dust off, and it attracts to it. And when you're done, you put it back in the washer and dryer, comes back out, boom. you can use it forever. This is the sweet mop cloth, and we're going to send you two of them, plus a DVD for your kid, your grandkid, or you want to give it to your Sunday school for Christmas, or maybe your Sunday school teacher, or a children's church worker. We have picked different educational DVDs. These are DVDs that you'll show. They're award-winning by our friend Carl Summer in Houston, Texas out there. These are summertime stories, and they build character in kids. This one, I Am a Lion. This is great. Stone Soup. This is about selfishness and how not to be selfish and share and things. This is the Little Red Train. Everybody knows about the Little Red Train.
Who doesn't, Kevin?
Think I can, I think I can, right? Yeah. Kind of deal. So this motivates your kid to work, because if you're lazy and don't work,
you
the Bible says in Proverbs.
The lion in the street, Kevin.
I don't know anything. That is a verse in Proverbs. I have no idea what that means, except that I guess if you're
yell
hollering,
at it,
there's
you're
a lion.
You're not going to do anything about it.
Yeah, the lion's going to be there. Yeah. Which.
There's
a DVD about a lion.
I'm a lion.
So I don't know, maybe that's about it too. We're sending you a DVD, the mop cloths. That's December's love gift. And those who join as a VIP, thank you in advance. Those that need to, come on. For $333, one-time gift, you come to Branson. We put you up for two nights. I take you personally to a dinner and a show, and we shower you with gifts, and you're a
up
VIP.
Up to twice a year.
Yeah, up to twice a year. Call ahead, and we'll have reservations made for you. And so, but now, this is awesome. We have thrown the shout out.
Mm-hmm.
We want to see every state that's, and eventually we're going to have a map. If our,
I got it today.
Did you get one finally? Yeah, you have a map.
I'm build it together.
We just have to show it, and we're going to put little stickers for everybody that's watching from different states. The first state to send in a dollar. We said send in a dollar, but you don't have to send it. Just send an envelope with your state on it, your address. Doesn't even have to your
watching.
Full address.
We'd like to see the
watching.
Viewers. Yeah.
Oklahoma was the first. Yay, Oklahoma. Ooh. Right where the wind comes through today. Well, yesterday, three more came in. Here we go. Here's one. Look at the back. It says,
I like the heart.
Can you see that? A heart. It says Arizona. So we've heard from Arizona. Did we? Yeah. Did they say? Dollar, Arizona.
Is.
Here we go. Alsup, Illinois. Illinois, the land of Lincoln, is in. And
no
Clinton, not Hillary. Indiana. This is Indiana. Yeah, so Indiana, Illinois, Arizona.
That's
and it's
awesome.
Really not about the dollar. I just really want to
like
see
to,
who's
yes,
out there.
Those states.
They tell us that there's, you know, potential viewership in the millions.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I don't care about millions of dollars. That would be nice.
It'd help.
But that's not what I want to see the 50 states. We've had so many of the called in. Matter of fact, we are coming to an area near you. We want next year. So if you can't come to us, we're going to come to you. So we're going to come to your area. We're going to do a concert. We'll have dinner with you in some
hotel. There's food,
hotel.
Kevin?
There's
I'm
food
in.
Involved. You know, with me, every meeting, everything.
I'll
we
see you there,
it's got to be food involved. So, you know, this month we made $4. Praise God.
That's awesome. Yeah.
No, but we want to just be a blessing to you. That's why we're here every
Speaking
day.
Speaking of being a blessing, Kevin.
Yes.
I heard a story the other day. Good testimony of the
show.
Oh,
it was a true story. Was this in Arkansas?
Yeah, I was
right?
in Arkansas. I was doing a concert with the show I'm in, Oh Happy Day.
Yeah.
You can check us out online. It's cool. But we were doing a concert, and this lady came up after me. She says, I watch you every day on the Kevin Shorey Show.
That's sweet.
Yeah, but she's a caretaker for the elderly, and she said there's this elderly man she took care of. Has this huge 65-inch TV because he can't really see, and he wears headphones because he can't really hear, elderly. But she said that he was watching it, and every time there's like Christian something on, he takes off the headphones, he looks away, he doesn't want to have it. But every day he watched your show.
Really?
And he said he gave his life to the Lord before he passed away. He passed away.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Watching the program.
That's nice.
Wanted nothing to do with Christian television or Christianity.
Oh, she said he would just take off the headphones. Didn't want to do it.
But yet, he watched the program, and we led him to the Lord. Oh, I don't know if I can go on. That just blesses me so much. That's awesome. We need a song, don't we?
We do.
We need a good song. You got a good song for us, Little Lee? Little Lee's a great regular here. When we do our concerts and we go on the road, we got to bring you with us, Little Lee. You down?
I'm down.
All right. So we're coming to Iowa. We're coming to Florida. They say our top 10 states that are in giving, of course, is Missouri is the number one, but California and Florida are in the top three. So we're coming to a city near you next year, and just to be a blessing to you and just to meet you. And so you can tell us the stories of the things that God is doing, not only in your life, but through our television program. But here's one of our favorites. I want to take him on tour with us for sure. Here's Little Lee. Come on.
Yeah.
paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Crowded streets, busy feet, hustle by him. Downtown shoppers, Christmas is nigh. And there he sits all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass him by. Should you stop? Better not. Much too busy. You're in a hurry. My how time does fly. In the distance, the ringing of laughter. And in the midst of the laughter, he cries. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue.
That's my buddy Little E. I love it. I love it. I love it. Who does that song? I love that song. Is that an Elvis song?
No.
Willie Nelson. Come on, Willie. You go, boy, with your high self. Anyway, it's Write a Friend Month through December. So write us, send it in the dollar if you want. You don't have to, but please let us know that you're watching us and where you're watching us from. And we will have a map eventually, or Justin will be fired. So we will have a map. Just kidding. But we appreciate hearing from you. And I forgot, I lost what I was going to say, but I just know that from the letters we're getting, we're making an impact, so we're going to stay on telling people that Jesus is the answer for the world today, and I just pray that you just pray with us. Oh, I know what I was going to say. If you hate the show, send in $2, all right? So that's what I was going to say. I shouldn't even have said that. But anyway, would you welcome back to the program? We're so honored to have him here. We just love all the projects that he's part of. They help us so much. Would you welcome Dr. Lee Fredrickson to the Kevin Shorey Show? Thank you, sir, for so much for being here today. Where do you abide?
Well, Kevin, first of all, thank you for having me back on your show.
Yes, sir.
And we just live a few minutes from here down in Springfield, Missouri.
Springfield, okay. Yeah, we love the Springfield. We had just a new VIP member from Springfield. Shout out to my brother. Yes. Yeah, we love Springfield. And we're on every day there with Channel 27 local.
And I watch you.
I like to keep that local station, even though we're on nationally, and you can get us in Springfield there too. But I love that KOZL Channel 27.
Yes.
You know, we come on there right after Andrew Womack and right before Two Guys and a Dog. I don't know, some show. But we have been offering, and to great success, the First Person New Testament. We love this. Now, you were part of this project as well with Dr. Elmer Towns, correct?
Well, I co-edited the paraphrase with Elmer Towns.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's just a great book. And Justin says it this way, and I love it. It's just like Jesus reading it to you, telling you his story. And this is a great gift, a great witnessing tool. And we still have those $20, a second one, $10. Great. And a lot of folks are getting that one and then one for the kids, like 12, 13 and under. Yeah. And this is, and Justin won't let me show all the pictures because he says they should buy it just so that they get the pictures, because it's so great in the anime. And this is the one true superhero, which he is faster than a speeding bullet and more stronger than a locomotive and can leap tall buildings. And his name is not Superman. His name is Jesus. Amen.
And by the way, this is also written in the first person. Right. So it's just like Jesus talking to you about his life story.
Yeah. Oh, it's just amazing. But now we've had the new. Now, tell me about how you got involved with this, the Family Prayer Bible, and why should everybody have one of those?
Well, I'm excited to talk to you about the Family Prayer Bible. But first of all, I'm going to tell you that as a child growing up in the little sleepy town of Ontonagon, Michigan, a block away from Lake Superior in Upper Michigan.
Sounds cold.
Very cold. Very cold.
I don't do cold.
We don't see grass until around May.
Yeah.
And around November, it starts to snow. So, but I remember growing up as a child, and every evening, my two brothers and three sisters would sit around the family dinner table. We would have dinner. And at the end of dinner, my dad would pick up our daily bread. And every dinner we would have our devotions, family devotions together. Sometimes I would read the scripture. And then at the end of our devotions, Dad would pray. To this day, I remember that as an impressionable time in my life. So when Dr. Towns approached me with the Family Prayer Bible, I said, wow, this brings back those memories. And so we collaborated together, and this is 365 days for family devotions, and it literally gives you and your family an overview of the Bible from Genesis to Revelation.
I like how it sets up the birth of Jesus. I mean, with the Old Testament devotions first, you know, and then comes Jesus. Christmas is what this is all about.
Well, yes.
And so it's a perfect Christmas gift, but not only the devotion or the reading of the scripture or the story, but then questions to talk about the story. And it sets you up. You can't fail with these kind of devotions.
Well, it gets the whole family involved, and that's the key to keeping families together. I see a family that prays together stays together.
Totally. Amen.
And I add to that a family that has devotions together. You can't imagine or even comprehend how much effect this has on your child, especially if Dad's involved.
Yes, sir.
And Mom.
Yeah, because it's kind of a rarity nowadays.
Yes.
You know, and so, and then if you're a single parent, you know, that's not to discredit you. I mean, a single parent is both. That's how I was raised. And Mom, you know, was Mom and Dad. Yes. But she made sure we had devotions. I mean, we had to say our prayers. There's a prayer here at the end. There's even the little box you can check off and put the date that you had this devotion.
Right.
So you either can go back to it, or you can say, now I've done that one, so we need to move on. Yes. And you can mix and match as you go, but I mean, it'll take you 365 days, right?
It sure will. And we also recommend that every Friday you have a family time together. And this is why we added to this book a special edition, a special coloring
drum
book.
Drum roll.
This is a coloring book for adults and kids to get involved on family family time.
Now, we've been talking about the Bible for a little bit here and offering it, but we are going to throw in no extra charges. This is for the gift of $50 or more, sent to you, free shipping. This is what he's talking about, the Family Prayer Bible coloring book for adults and kids. That's why I love this. I'm a big kid. Yes. I still like to color. Right. I was coloring before the show. See my little... No, I didn't color it. But I wanted to. I didn't have any crayons. But like you were saying, there's... Aside for the adults, a little more intricate coloring thing, and it tears out. There's a perforation here.
Yeah, it is frameable.
Yeah, frameable. Yes. And it matches the prayer Bible, right?
The illustration matches that illustration for the week, so they can color the illustration, and they can use the book as a reference.
Yeah. No, it's perfect. So they got the simple side for them to, you know, the kids to color. And then look at that one. Look at that eagle that you have to color right there. Ooh, that's a challenge. I'm sorry. Goodbye. We're leaving the show now. I have to color. This is the eagle. Let's see. Well, no, I don't have any crayons. Can't do it. But we are throwing that in. But more than just offering it to you, and it helps our ministry, and this is a gift to say thank you. Why do you feel? Because you have invested your life in editing a lot of these kind of Bibles. Yes. why do people need the Word of God in their life? I mean, these families, we really need it, don't we?
Well, this goes beyond just an average devotion. This takes you into the Scripture. You learn valuable lessons from Scripture, and also you're taught doctrine and how to live. You're absorbed in it with the family prayer Bible. Mm-hmm. We're so excited. We're already seeing lives changed. I remember getting this from Otis Ledbetter, pastor of a Sunrise Church in Clovis. He said that after they had sold the family prayer Bible to their congregation, one of the kids came to church that next week and said, "I can't wait to get home. My dad's going to read the Bible to me." And it was the family prayer Bible.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, for someone saying that this seems so antiquated, you know, this is so outdated because you're so into the videos and the video games and the DVDs and the this and that. And it's time for families to build a foundation. I don't know that I'm going to start any trends here, but we really need to go back to the basics, not only of knowing the Word of God, but setting that foundation for the next generation. I mean, millennials, I don't know. I've given up on millennials. No, but God hasn't, thank God. But, you know, the next generation that's coming up after them, we have created such a selfish, almost, entitlement generation in some ways. And I know I'm stereotyping because that's not everybody. There is a great revival happening in our young people today and millennials. But I'm afraid of the next generation if we don't implant in them the true Word of God, not our words, but the Word of God, and taking time away from the TV, the computer. Most of the kids are not even on TV anymore. They're on the computer day and night or their phones, putting them aside and actually reading. And it doesn't take long, right? These devotions aren't more than 20, 30 minutes max.
20 minutes.
You know, and then the coloring time, you say, well, that just seems so... No, sit next to your kid, lay next to him, sit next to him, get on the floor with him, and color. I mean, this would just be an amazing thing to do for just to build the foundation that we need. And I'm going to do more of that on the soapbox in a minute about that. But would you just pray? Would you, Doctor, can you pray for families and just pray that Jesus will be real in their life, especially at Christmas time? And there's many families that are hurting and struggling. Just that God will just be real in their life. And also pray, if you would, I'm giving you a list, but pray that moms and dads will just have the courage and the comfort of the Holy Spirit to step out and do devotions. Because a lot of times, I don't know what to say. I'm not really a preacher. Well, we've done it for you. You can do it that way, but they need the help of the Holy Spirit. Would you just pray for families right now?
Dear Father, I'm praying today for those families out there, maybe one particular family who's been struggling with their family, their children, and wondering, how can I bring them back to Christ? How can I give them a desire to even go to church on Sundays? And Lord, I pray that you would touch them, that they could be touched with the family prayer Bible, and that they would see their children once again have this love for the Bible, love for others, and love for you. And I thank you so much that we're going to have that opportunity to touch their lives today. And I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Call or write today. Not just to order. I'd love for you to order that. And if you do, let us know those testimonies. But if you prayed the prayer and you felt the Holy Spirit to help you, let us know that. And we're having a lot of people calling and telling us that one lady called yesterday from Fort Worth, Texas. Bless you so much. You blessed me. And she could barely talk. She was crying so much because of the program that ministered to her. This is what keeps us going. And you can help keep us going with your finances. But you definitely motivate me if you'll call or write. 209-44-KEVIN is the phone number. You can write to P.O. Box 1122, Branson, Missouri, 65615. Do that today and just let us know what this program means to you. With all kidding set aside, I always tell the joke, all seriousness aside, but this time, all kidding set aside, we really, really want to be a blessing to you. And if you have any critiques, send it our way. You know, I wear my big man pants, all right, so I can take it. But if you have something negative to say, make sure you add $1,000 with that negative saying. I'll be back right after this important message. This is another way you can help us. And when we come back, I'm going to get on my soapbox and tell you, finish up the program.
Mom! What happened?
I fell down and scraped my elbow.
I ran into a thorn bush while I was hiking.
I've got
got mauled by 15 raccoons.
Do you have woundies?
Never leave without it.
Woundies, an all-natural wound healing gel good for cuts, scrapes, and abrasions. Order yours today for only $25 or 3 for 60. Woundies, it can fix anything.
Okay, you two are all set.
Thanks, Mom.
What about me?
You need to go to the hospital.
Woundies, it can fix almost anything.
And we're back, and I'm on my soapbox. What a great program today. Thank you, Dr. Fredrickson, and little E, of course, always comes with a cool song or two. And so we just want to invite you to watch us live. If you watch us on Roku or watch us live on kevinshorey.com, little E sings another song for us live, and we do some extra stuff that's really fun. You want to watch us live, go to kevinshorey.com. Go there and tell us what you think about the program. And vote for it. And let us hear what state you're from. You can even email us and let us know where you're from. But you can call us, 209-44-KEVIN, or write to P.O. Box 1122. That's 1122, Branson, Missouri, 65615. But here's why I really, really, really feel that giving out Bibles and blessing with the Word of God, not only a foundation for our family and what everybody needs, but it's the Christmas message as well. What does John 1 say? In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. That is the Christmas message. Jesus came in the flesh. Jesus is the Word. And so that's why we need to spread the Word. That's why we need to read the Word. Know what the Word of God says. I say it all the time. Read the book. Don't wait for the movie. Hollywood messes it up 9 times out of 10. So read what the Bible really says. How will the next generation, how will our children know unless we share? Some of the best times I remember in my life is my grandmother and my mother reading the Bible to us, telling us Bible stories that went into our heart. I have the Word of God on my heart. The Bible says, hide the Word in your heart so you won't sin against Him. And this is what we need more than ever in our day and age. So that's why we're promoting the Word. Get one of our Bibles, but get a Bible, get into the Word. At Christmas time, make sure you're reading the Word before you open up presents, because the greatest gift is Jesus. That's right. Jesus is the answer for your world today. That's what we say today and every day. We'll be back tomorrow with another special guest. We'll see you then.
The world-famous Branson Mill at 3300 North Gretna Road, where art meets entertainment, featuring the Corner Store Studio, friendly staff, hundreds of shops, demonstrations, crafts, snacks, classes, artwork, fun for all ages, the Treehouse Cafe. All under one roof at the world-famous Branson Mill, where art meets entertainment.
Promotional consideration provided by Meyer Hotels.
The preceding program was brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.